Right, the fifth of our five trainers in the spotlight that made headlines over the weekend is indeed, appropriately, Dandy Nichols, who has just won our latest race here at Redcar. And he had three winners Friday and Saturday. Hamoudi won for him at Haydock, and Bonnie Charlie at Thirsk, and down at Ascot, Mark, was the main one.
It was. Don't Call Me won the big handicap down there, the 7 furlong horse. Dandy's done a tremendous job with him, but a couple of years ago for only 12,000. So just thought an appropriate time to flag up Dandy. Excellent weekend for him. We know he's got the Western meeting just round the corner, and I'm sure he'll be sending as many horses as he can find there.
I think it's fair to say he's had largely a sort of patchy sort of season, yeah. But nevertheless, and most encouragingly, they seem to be in better form sort of now and have been lately than probably at any prolonged time in the year.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. I think it's widely accepted. It's been a tough year for Dandy, but winners-wise, he is down compared to last year, which is his personal best 12 months ago. But percentage-wise, I think it's fairly similar, 10 or 11%. But they've really picked up the last 2 or 3 weeks, really. They appear to be in good form. He won't be sending the colour of horse to wear in a couple of weeks compared to a few years ago. But he'll still be sending some decent horses up there. Don't Call Me himself, I'm sure he'll be going up there. But he's been a real flag bearer the last couple of years. Fourth in a Royal Hunt Cup, won a £50,000 handicap at the weekend as well. Hamoudi, I know he's not the horse he used to be, but Dandy got him back to his best, somewhere near his best on Friday, and he was very good.
Yeah, let's take a look at Hamoudi, because it was quite interesting, this horse winning. Interesting as much as it was quite significant that he was well backed.
It was really well backed, yeah. He got his conditions on Friday. Fast ground, I think Francis Norton was riding for the first time here, and he showed that telling turn of foot. He, as I say, he's not the horse he used to be. He was winning the Richmond about 5 or 6 years ago, but he dropped to a good mark. There was plenty of money around for him, and Dandy produced him on the day spot on, and he won well. He shows a really good turn of foot later on.
Yeah, he does. I mean, you know, I would imagine he could go up to air, Mark. I mean, you know, this is his sort of level. But there'll be a race up there for him.
I would have thought so, yeah. He's probably better five, isn't he, than he's over.
I think there is a 5 furlong handicap there, though, isn't there?
So, yeah, I'm pretty sure there is. So that will be a possibility. He's probably a better horse on quickish ground, so you're hoping the ground conditions will be ideal for him. But it's just good to see him back to something like his old form. Let's hope he can pick up another before the end of the year.
Yeah, and Bonnie Charlie was another one for him over the weekend. That was at Thirsk, of course. And good to see him win, too.
It was, yeah. He's been a frustrating horse the last couple of seasons. Another horse who was very good in his younger days. He was a high class juvenile, lost his way slightly, but he was back to form with a win at the weekend. Wasn't a strong handicap by any means, but it's just good to see him back to something like some of his better form in recent years. It was a competitive race, even though it wasn't the strongest of races.
He's always been a horse that's had that kind of bit of a fan club, really, and probably his fans have dropped out in the meantime, but he's still capable on his day.
Well, Saturday proved that there is still some ability there, isn't it? Because there's a two-year-old, I think Richard Hannan had him, he was running in races like the Horace Hill, William Haggis had him for a spell, then he ended up at Dandy. He's been a frustrating horse, but at least he got a win against his name. But, you know, just in, as I say, in recent times, Dandy's had a good spell, tax-free. We saw him win at the Ebor Festival, the first race on the Wednesday. Great to see him run such a good race, an enthusiastic horse. He might be a 10-year-old, but there's still plenty of ability and, more importantly, enthusiasm there.
Yeah, and the recent success stories, Mark, Addictive Dream was one of them.
Well, he was, yeah. Dandy's usually a big player at the end of season sales, sort of October, new market horses in training sales, and he bought Addictive Dream. He's quite an expensive horse, but almost immediately he was rewarded. He won twice in May down at the start of the year, so he did his stuff. He hasn't had a lot of racing since, but you know, if you're gearing a horse up for May down at that time of the year, you're not going to have him running all year.
Mm. And there's another popular horse, Evens and Odds, who was the Stewards' Cup winner in 2010.
Yeah, well, there's a few others we'll see on the following page who for whatever reason, they're no longer with Dandy. But I'm just really highlighting what he's done with these sort of horses over the years. Redford, he wasn't a Dandy's long, but he didn't do badly with him, did he? He won an Air Gold Cup the following week, won that big handicap at Ascot. Yeah. Regal Parade. There won't be many better bargain buys than him for 17,000 for what he achieved.
No, he's certainly not. Won two Group 1s and then followed up with the Air Gold Cup. And look at Dandy's record in the Air Gold Cup as well. Unprecedented.
Yeah, well, it's going to be difficult for him this year. I don't know how many runners he'll end up in the race, but it's been a fantastic achievement. You've got to remember, one of those years he didn't even enter a horse as well, didn't he? So it marks it up even better. For whatever reason, some horses are no longer there that were there at the start of the season. So I think it's all about, you can only do with what sort of ammunition you've got. And he hasn't had the horses as he had 2 or 3 years ago. So I think in the circumstances, you look at his percentage, he hasn't done badly.
Yeah, let's just take a look at some of Dandy's big race successes as well, just to remind us. There, Don't Call Me and Tax Free. These are just the recent ones. So we're just sort of going over more or less, summarising what we've said. But, you know, Tax Free, that was a tremendously memorable success on Frankel's Day at York.
It was, yeah, first day of the Ebor Festival. 10-year-old now, as I say, plenty of enthusiasm there. He's been on the go for such a long time. In Exile as well, another of his stablemates that ran at the weekend at York. He's been strutting his stuff over in Ireland as well. Almost every year you can rely on him to be picking up a pattern race over there.
Yeah, and he won a listed race, I think it was Tipperary, about two starts ago as well. He's been a wonderful servant to the yard in Exile and made a good fist of it again the other day at York as well. Let's take a look at his seasonal totals. Obviously, you know, they're going to fluctuate towards now from where they were, but he hasn't got the ammunition.
No, as I mentioned, you know, you look at some of last year was his personal best season. That was a fantastic season. You look at that and you look at 38 and you think that's desperately disappointing. But if the ammunition's not there, Victoire de Lifar, for whatever reason, he's not fired now, he's left. Regal Parade's left. James Bowes Girl, that won a couple of times, got claimed now with Richard Fahey. Paramore's left. So I don't know why they've left, but horses have left. So if you haven't got the ammunition, you're not going to get the winners.
No, without a doubt, but still a very capable trainer. And as we've just seen here with Albert Tatlock, wins at all levels, particularly specialises in sprinters, and no doubt, come air, whatever his level of ammunition, he's going to be there or thereabouts in quite a few of the races up there. That's David Nichols and a team that is going great guns at the moment.